Today I want to share some of the problems I encountered when upgrading to Windows 10 on my computers. The problems I'm going to talk about all happened on one device, but I encountered some of the same problems when upgrading some of my other devices, and so they may be the same problems you guys encounter. So on the day that Windows 10 was publicly released, I signed into my machine and nothing. I was hoping to be amongst the first few waves of people upgrading, so I was a little disappointed by the lack of an update, but then I realised that an ISO file would probably be available, and so a quick Google took me to the page where I could download the media creation utility. I downloaded the tool, and something happened. Once I got over the initial shock of such a useful error message, I Googled something happened and found that there were a lot of people suggesting that I change the region of my machine to United States in the region and language settings, which I did, but something was still happening. I was thinking about the problem a little more, and it crossed my mind that the media creation utility would probably download the relevant files through the same system as Windows Update downloads its updates. Windows Update also has a section which says that my copy of Windows 10 had been reserved, so it seems that Windows Update was indeed connected to the upgrade process, but then I noticed that the Windows Update program had failed to download available updates. Some serious Googling led me to the Background Intelligent Transfer Service, or BITS, which is the underlying technology used to download updates, which seemed to be somehow corrupted. Fortunately, I found this website which mentions that the registry key could go missing, so I opened regedit and sure enough the key was missing. I added it in and Windows Update roared into life, downloading and installing all of the updates currently outstanding. Once all of the updates had installed and after restarting the machine, I tried the media creation utility again and success. It started downloading the Windows 10 ISO file. I mounted the ISO file to a USB thumb drive and began the installation process, which went smoothly until it didn't. After the installation process restarted the computer, I was greeted with this error message telling me that the boot drive had caused the upgrade to fail, so back to Google I went. This time the answer was to assign a drive letter to a 100MB partition on my hard drive I didn't even know existed. Once the drive letter was assigned, I could then delete all of the language packs which I wasn't currently using, and then trim the length of a log file to make sure that there was enough space for the upgrade to go ahead. Just a note about this step as well though, which wasn't covered in a web page I used for the solution. When you're trying to access the boot folder, I needed to type the path into the address bar, so in this case it was y:/boot. It didn't actually show as a folder like you would expect it to. And so I once again began the installation process, and this time no problems at all. Windows 10 installed properly with no error messages. After a quick look around, I checked out the system page to make sure that my installation had been properly activated, and of course it was. I had decided beforehand that I wanted to actually do a clean install after upgrading, and so when I knew that my Windows key had been properly activated, I began the process of doing a clean install. If you're going to do a clean install, I do have a couple of words of caution before you begin. Most importantly is the fact that you do need to do an in-place upgrade from Windows 7, 8 or 8.1 to activate your Windows 10 key as being valid before you can actually do a clean upgrade. Otherwise, Microsoft won't recognise your computer as having a genuine copy of Windows. It's also of course important to make sure that you back up all of your files that you want to keep, because they will be deleted during the process otherwise. Finally, it's also probably a good idea to make a note of all of the programs that you want to reinstall afterwards, and making sure that you have all of the information that you're going to need to actually do the reinstall. So for example, making sure that you have the key codes for all of the programs that you're going to reinstall. So having already activated Windows 10, the clean installation process went extremely smoothly. Just one interesting point though, during the installation process, I deleted the 100MB system partition I mentioned earlier, and allowed the installation to create a new partition. This time, however, the partition was 500MB, so Microsoft is obviously aware that 100MB isn't enough space. Another problem I encountered on another machine was the upgrade process failing because I didn't have the latest drivers for the Nvidia graphics card in the machine. Just downloading and installing the latest drivers from Nvidia's website was enough to fix this problem though. Hopefully all of these problems will be resolved as Microsoft reacts to the feedback it receives from people going through the upgrade process, but I did want to make this available in case it will help anyone else out. So how was the upgrades process for you? Has this video helped you upgrade? Let me know in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe.